Alright, so there's this issue where SE module package can't unpackage a module located in each CS Linux targeted. So let's see, do I have a shell somewhere? I do. So I guess I'll need to reproduce it. So there were some hints there that the Fedora package basically does an extra bzip on the module, and that might cause the issue. And I'm not sure if that actually makes sense to do that. So let's just do first things first. Let's just see. And I'll just do everything. Actually, I'll just do it on the system. Build a package, an up-to-date SE Linux policy package with a modification where it doesn't do the bzip stuff. So I have this node here that tells me how to do that quickly, hopefully. Let's checklist modify Fedora 20 RPM. So I'm just going to follow this checklist. Make there my temp. CD my temp. And then just follow this checklist here. And build a updated SE Linux policy package with a modification to see if that might actually help. Would be nice if it would be that simple, but I don't think the issue is that simple actually. I think there's more at play here. Fat package prep to prep the stuff. Oh, and actually I didn't even have to do that. It's just a change to the spec file. So this is actually not needed at all, but it doesn't hurt either. It's just a change to the spec file. Nano Linux policy spec. I'll just use nano. I shouldn't, but easy to, I guess. So here it does here it does some stuff. Basically, it bzips the base module and sends it to I wonder how that should be passed down. Weird. Why does it do the base package separately? Builder, it's configured there. That's rather weird. Not sure. Let's just see. So that's done. And basically, I should do a bump spec. then affects local. See if this actually builds. I'm not sure if I did that install stuff properly. We'll see, I guess. Also minimal packages and MLS packages. There's some XML issues there. This is going to take a little while due to my incompetence. It's also super slow due to my audit rules. Probably should have done this on the test system instead. That's not gonna happen. It's all target. It's not gonna happen. Oh, that's. What's it saying? Target. It's not a directory. Yeah, I know that that's not a directory. Well, that's clueless. Goddamn weather here is bad for my God damn it. Typical Dutch weather. Wet. That's its file directory. fuck? God damn it. No, this isn't gonna work. Slow because it's writing audit records for every file it deletes. Shit. What the hell is this doing there? It's old. this annoying as hell. How also annoying that you don't have a proper full screen. Oh, Bisa. What if I just do... Maybe that's gonna happen. Nah, it's probably gonna rain. It's swamp weather. Cloudy as shit. If I would be able to deal with this shit. Don't know why I'm doing this, but since I'm doing it, I might as well try to finish it. But if this doesn't work, then I'll probably just abort. Fuck it. Not my job. Manual pages, this is gonna take a while. Oh, I didn't bump the spec. Okay, so it did actually build this time. Let's see what that looks like. Probably need the targeted package. Not open with Archive Manager and see what it got. Modules active. Base BP is here. And the policy packages seems to be installed, type modified. Or seems to be copied. So in theory this might be okay. In theory. So I have this script somewhere. That'll set up a system, LSRZ dev. Rep SDL. I think it's SDL. This is the disk that I use for virtual machines. So it's gen KS gen KS system name test root passwords ABC 123 username go. Use password ABC123 and then C for console only install. And does that look right? Looks right. And then just basically sudo home show. Gen KS and then it's test install and the disk path is dev SDL1. time this will install the system, hopefully. Meanwhile, I can do a shell, get the IP address. Actually, I can just go to cd var or ls varlib. What is it? Libvirt DNS. And this is network one, network one, at least. Oh, there's no leases there yet. Oh, there's actually network two. Network three, I'm sorry. So yeah, this is a system that has IP address of 200.212.8.192.168.200.212. But it's not up yet. And actually, it's not gonna be up anytime soon. Here's that test network 3. It's still installing. Once it's done, it needs to be started up again because it's not restarting for some reason if you do console. Okay, power off. You just need to power it on again. Yeah, run it. And then connect to it, and then just reproduce the issue, and then install the new package and see if that issue persists after this change. Actually, just let's just cpetc as a Linux targeted modules active modules, and then LVM, PP, and then CP that in here. And then basically SE module and package LVM, PP, LVM, mod, and LVM. See, hopefully it's installed. It's not even installed. Yum, what provides. Let's see, module and package. Probably policy core utils as your module. Yeah, that's most likely. Yum, install policy core utils. God damn it. Annoying as shit. Devel. This is pretty well thought out. Oh, and it's actually updating the policy. Oh, it's slow as shit. Okay, let's try SE module on package again. And you have that issue, that stupid fucking issue. So, RM, LVM, PP. Yeah. Okay. So now let's just see the, actually let's just first get that fucking package, LCD, what is it, Joe, my temp, LCD. 20. It's no arch. LCD. No arch. And there you have it. And then it's basically put. This one here. And put this one here. And supposedly that should be fine. Fuck the valve as well. I'll be goddamned. Okay, so set up for a CD shell. Set up for 0. This is not gonna work. Oh, that's not even a half bad. Yeah, let's not install that by default as a Linux policy. Fuck. As a Linux policy. Target. Pretty fucking messy. And this depends on I'll be damned, so this Linux policy devel depends on policy core details devel. Policy core details devel depends on as Linux policy devel. But I think I have an excuse for that. Okay, so now CPE, EPC, as a Linux, targeted modules, active modules, LVMPP. As a module, and package. LVMPP LVM mod LVM, and this actually works, so yeah, that's the issue. So yeah, let's see, so let's just set a force one as the module B. See if this shit even builds. And it would be interesting to see if there's a huge difference. But that doesn't make sense, doesn't make a difference. So let's just take a few tests, so like SoapMinder 105k targeted. God damn it. Oh yeah, that's it, deinstalled it, so yeah. It's probably empty. See, yeah, it's pretty much empty. Anyways, setup force one. PS out LSLZ / shut down reboot now. Shutting down at 12:04. Get a force disabled. What fuck? Yep. Something is right. Oh, right. Now, see as it is. Perfect. Yeah, well. What a mess. See if that actually happens. With relabeling. So yeah, it seems actually that it's that easy. We're back in business. Clean. So yeah, that's actually the whole issue. Let's just take another. let's just take snapper. Did I see snapper? Yeah. So let's just. And it just works. Dot snapper. This just works. But this is as this mod, but it's probably not installed. Is. Okay. So yeah, this fixes it. So what the diff is, this is the diff. Except these, of course, because I set these to off for to make building it quicker. But this is the diff here. But what I did is probably stupid, ugly hack. But you get the idea, yeah.